But if you've still got inflation way higher, if you've got the services economy raising prices, if you've got insurance premiums going up by 20%, if you've got heating prices in many cases going up by 50%, it's very difficult to get that inflation out anytime soon.
Well, that's the problem, and that's the real risk here that the market's starting to cotton on to, is that we're going to get all these price rises on 1 July, and we may not get that 4% inflation result for this current year, the current forecast for most economists, the RBA. And, of course, that means we won't get the real interest rate to zero unless the RBA starts taking that cash rate above 5. So the market's really starting to sort of lose its patience. I think the RBA may be starting to lose its patience. And, of course, we're really opening the door here to an interest rate here in Australia that's got to match what we're seeing in places like the United States, New Zealand.
But as most bank economists and you have said for a long time, if you have that scenario play out, the inflation doesn't disappear, you've got to jam up the rates to actually try and get it, then the risk of Australia tipping into recession, shallow, deep, whatever it might be, is increased as a result.
I think we're not going to get out of this without a recession. It's just whether it's a mild, short-term technical recession, effectively a soft landing that's a little bumpier than a normal soft landing, or whether we have a genuine hard landing recession. The difference between the two is whether the RBA cash rate goes to 4.35 or 4.6, or whether it has to go to 5.5.
But at the moment, you've got full employment. You don't have banks with any real credit issues. That's a fundamental difference, which suggests that the recession, if it does occur, is more of a slowdown, not necessarily a crisis.
At this stage, the banks look good. And of course, that's when a recession turns nasty, is when banks are so impaired that they can't extend credit to the economy. That's the early 90s recession. And, of course, we're a long way from that at the moment.
We're a long way from that. That's fascinating to see. Anyway, Warren Hogan, always good to have you in the program, and many thanks for your time today.
Thanks, Ross.